It's the 43rd CIAA Tournament Men's Finals. This week's game is being brought to you by Mobil 1 Synthetic Motor Oil. Mobil 1 protects your engine better than any conventional motor oil. Also by Budweiser, proud sponsor of the 1988 U.S. Olympic team. This Bud's for you. And by Polaroid Pictures. Hold the picture in your hand while the feeling is still in your heart.
The Scope in Norfolk, Virginia. We're live for the 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. Virginia State Trojans come on to take on the Spartans of Norfolk State. Hello again, everyone. I'm Charlie Neal, and anytime you talk about CIAA basketball, you talk about exciting tournament action, and especially when it has moved back here to the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia after a two-year absence. The city of Norfolk has been very happy in the fact that they were able to get the tournament back here in Norfolk, and of course, we've had sellouts the last couple of days, and now it's down to the real nitty-gritty. It's crunch time. Norfolk State, they've been here before. It's been a long time since Virginia State has been in the CIAA tournament. Working with me, Sam Jones, a former player in the CIAA, and Sam also not only played in the CIAA, he's on my left, Greg Kelso on my right. He coached in the CIAA. When you talk about what Coach Dean has done with the Trojans of Virginia State, he's done a fantastic job this year, and to come away with that big upset win over Virginia Union last night had to be a big feather in his cap.
Coach Harold Dean's, he's been away for 8 years, Charlie, but he's got this team playing. He's got a young man by the name of Lennon Harris, who is 6'7", about 220. He's going to go to the boards. He's averaging something like 21 points a ball game. Also, David Blackwell, who is a senior this year, 6'9". He can play, Charlie. He's going to get better. They want to win tonight. And then at guard, they have Lamont Walker. He's like the two guard. He's doing a great job out there. I'd like to say one thing. I like the freshman. This kid is only 5'10", and he is a player.
You're talking about Chris Holloway. He's the guard. But let's go back to the semifinal game of last night. When you talk about Lamont Walker, Lamont Walker hit the winning shot at the buzzer to beat Virginia Union, and he almost didn't get it off. He bobbled the ball.
He bobbled the ball. He got it off, and I saw this ball when the clock went off. That ball looked like it was going in, and it went swoosh. And as you know, 12,000 people went to a hush, and all of a sudden they came out because Virginia State had defeated Virginia Union.
And that's something they hadn't done this year. Again, they've lost to Norfolk State twice this year. That's hard to beat a team three times in one season. Norfolk State's going to have their work cut out for them.
Oh, especially with a rivalry like that. They're just across town about 20 miles from each other. And, of course, Dave Robbins, he doesn't like to be a spectator. He hasn't been for many, many years. But tonight, it's all Trojans from Virginia State.
Okay, Greg Kelser, when you talk about the Spartans of Norfolk State, we know that the keys in their semifinal victory were a couple of players who don't play a lot. They came off the bench. Talk about them a little bit.
Well, Guy Fauntleroy, as you mentioned, does not play a lot, but he came in and got some key steals, 5 points, and really played some tough defense. And a guy, Clinton Wright, who also doesn't get a lot of time, he came in. He's a freshman, by the way, and he did a fine job. And they're largely the reason why Norfolk State is here in this championship game.
Okay, those are the reserves. The reserves did a good job for them. But how about the people who play all the time, the regulars, the guys like Antonio Stith?
Well, Stith played well last night in the first half when the team was struggling. Of course, he, along with Walker and Coles and Lee Johnson, are very good players starting. Lee Johnson really stepped into the forefront after this team lost the conference's two best players, in my estimation, Ralph Talley and Barry Mitchell last year. And certainly Charles Christian has done a fine job coaching this club.
Okay, and then, of course, in addition to Antonio Stith, we got James Walker and Lee Johnson, all good players, and it should be a whale of a contest. The 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament is the championship game, and we'll be back with the starting lineups and the opening tip-off in just a moment.
Johnson. At this time, the national anthem will be sung by Dr. A.L. Bradford.
Charlie Neal, along with Sam Jones, Greg Kelser, is the championship game of the CIAA tournament, the 43rd annual CIAA tournament. Virginia State against Norfolk State. 1947 was the first and only time that Virginia State has won the CIAA tournament. The last time they were in the championship game was 1981, and they lost that game to Elizabeth City. So it's been few and far between for the Trojans of Virginia State, as the 43rd annual CIAA tournament is about to get underway. And Al Roseboro is our PA announcer, and we're gonna throw it to him now for the introduction of tonight's starting lineups.
And hope that you will enjoy the championship game, as it will be played by two of the top teams in the Northern Division of the CIAA, the Trojans of Virginia State University of Petersburg, Virginia, will face the Spartans of Norfolk State University of Norfolk, Virginia. Of the lineups. First, the Trojans of Virginia State University. A 5'7 guard from Hopewell, Virginia, wearing jersey number 10, Chris Holloway. A 5'10 guard from Norfolk, Virginia, wearing jersey number 11, Lamont Walker. At the center spot, standing 6'9", from Portsmouth, Virginia, wearing jersey number 33, David Blackwell. The forward slot, standing 6'7", from Hopewell, Virginia, wearing jersey number 34, Leonard Harris. the other forward, standing 6'4", from Hanover, Virginia, wearing jersey number 42, Brian Price. Head coach for the Trojans, Harold Dean. His assistants are Mike Coleman, Harry Bradley, and Buffy Wilcox. Now for the Spartans of Norfolk State University. At the guard, standing 6'2", from Norfolk, Virginia, wearing jersey number 13, Antonio Stitt. At the other guard, wearing jersey number 22, standing 6'2", from Suffolk, Virginia, Anthony Reed. At the center spot, standing 6'9", from Miami, Florida, wearing jersey number 30, Lee Johnson. At the forward slot, standing 6'3", from Prince George, Virginia, wearing jersey number 20, Jane Walker. At the forward slot, standing 6'7", from Lexington, Kentucky, wearing jersey number 42, Jerome Cole. Head coach for the Spartans, Charles Christian. His assistants are Gerald Wilkerson, Tom Snowden, and Jim Flowers. Your officials for this contest, referee Jim Birch, umpire one, Larry Rose, umpire two, Bill Chief.
So, we're ready to go. The 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament, Virginia State and Norfolk State, and we're about to get underway here. Leonard Harris, Jalamont Walker, Chris Holloway, Brian Price, and David Blackwell for the Trojans. Stiff, along with Lee Johnson, Jerome Coles. They're also starting Anthony Reed at the guard spot. Jim Birch, who's retiring after this year as a referee after 29 years, tosses it up and Norfolk State controls the opening tap. This is Antonio Stith. He's working against Chris Holloway. Holloway, the little short guy, and then we got a steal right away. Brian Price takes it down the court, puts it in, and Virginia State draws first blood, 2-0.
And you'll notice that they're starting out on a man-to-man with Norfolk State.
Man-to-man defense is Price working against Reed, Holloway working against Stiff. You got Lee Johnson inside, and the basket by Antonio Stiff. It's tied at 2 apiece.
There's a tendency to do that with success, demonstrated for the most part last night by Antonio Stiff. He can penetrate, and he knows when to drop it off and when to shoot it.
Plus the fact he's got a small man on him, so he can take advantage of that.
And a foul is going to be whistled against Lee Johnson, as David Blackwell, the 6'9 senior from Portsmouth, Virginia, took it up very, very strong.
Charlie, there's and Sam, there's number 10 in there, and Sam, I know you like him a lot, Holloway. You feel he's the key to this game. Made a sensational pass inside to Blackwell.
You know, Holloway is only a freshman at that, and to be playing before 12,000 people tonight, maybe more people, and Coach Dean giving him that authority to be the second coach on the floor.
David Blackwell makes it a 3-2 lead for the Trojans, who in the tournament here beat Shaw 95-63, St. Augustine's 89-86, and Virginia Union 75-73 in the semifinal game. And that's what got them here. It is 3-2, Virginia State by one. Antonio Stiff, bounce pass over to Anthony Reed. The young man we watched, Jerome Coles, earlier this year, Sam, trying to get loose underneath, trying to post up.
One thing I like about Jerome, he works very hard under the basket.
And he just got a tip in.
He just got a tip because he's always moving. It's hard to play one-on-one.
And he's just a freshman. He's going to be a good one. He's out of Lexington, Kentucky. Holloway.
Good matchup underneath will be Coles. You just talked about him. And Leonard Harris, Virginia State. Harris, in my opinion, a super basketball player and is playing on a mission, so to speak, after having been ignored by all the postseason pickers, you might say, for honors last year.
Ryan Price with that last basket, Sam.
Hey, this kid's been averaging around 15 points a game, and he's got an excellent shot.
Got it back. Reed has it knocked away. Blackwell came down with it. Here's Holloway. Cross court. They're going to call a blocking foul. He makes so many things happen. He is so quick. Chris Holloway, and he's just a freshman. He's from Hopewell, Virginia. Let's watch him.
Well, you look at Holloway. We said last night in the game against Virginia Union, he didn't make any mistakes. And with that foul being called on the Norfolk State player, he's still injury-free. Error-free.
He does move. You can see it on the TV.
James Walker picked up the personal foul. Two team fouls against Norfolk State already. The score is 5-4 in favor of Virginia State. And here's Holloway. The quickness. Dumps it off to Walker, and he's blocked. The players crash under the basket.
And they're both hurt.
Hurt down under the basket. Well, they're finally getting up. Lamont Walker and Antonio Stiff went crashing. Short.
Now he's not hurt anymore.
Blackwell, David Blackwell makes it 6. Make it 7-4. 3-point lead. Watch it.
You know you get well off it quick when you see that ball coming back the other way on offense.
This is true, and we just had a slam dunk competition. Blackwell had not been playing in this game, could have been in there with that move.
You better believe it.
But you notice most big men are not in slam dunk competitions. The guys are like 6'4", 6'5". Normally you don't have those 6'9", 11, 7-footers in there. And the layup is missed by Leonard Harris, but the follow-up again, and he misses it. Henley Johnson pulls down the rebound with 16:40 remaining in the first half.
Maybe a little bit tight right now.
I think so. This is a big game, and certainly once they settle down, they'll all play well.
Had the basket. He had a pass to the basket, and he hurt himself again.
Charlie Stith is hurt. He got hurt on that crash on the other end of the basket.
He's going to have to come out of this game.
7-6 is the score, and you're looking at Antonio Stith, the sophomore out of Norfolk, who's a starter at the guard. He was a sixth man a year ago, and he is down in pain. There's a timeout on the floor while they are attending to Antonio Stiff. We'll be back. 16-19 remaining in the first half. A one-point lead for the Virginia State Trojans. They're attending to the leg of Antonio Stiff, his left leg. We'll see how much it will hurt the Spartans of Norfolk State. We'll watch the play where he may have gotten hurt or re-injured himself after the crash with Lamont Walker at the other end earlier.
And that's just what happened. He could not get off the floor. And he limped all the way down on that crash. And this is why he's still hurting. But I'm sure that Antonio will be back.
He came into the game with a 5.6 average throughout the season. But in the tournament here, in three games, he's averaged over 9 points per game and 5.3 assists. 5-second violation, closely guarded. And the turnover, as you look at Harold Dean, who's done a great job. First year after an 8-year absence from the school, he's back here and has them rolling 22-8.
Virginia State's guards, both of the small variety, have caused a lot of problems for Norfolk State's guards in the early going. 2 turnovers so far.
Blackwell can't get the ball, but the tip in, credit the basket to number 32, Everett Watkins, a freshman. He is from Richmond, Virginia. 15:49 remaining, 9-6, 3-point lead for the Trojans of Virginia State. In the lineup now, Carlos Thomas, he's replacing Antonio Stiff. And it'll be Chris Holloway drawing the personal foul.
You mentioned Sam Holloway, 5'7".
Chris Holloway.
He's a player that can be posted up. But out here right now with Reed, they're the same size because it's very difficult to handle the ball that far out against a man that small.
And I certainly think that Norfolk State has got to see that and take advantage of those small guards.
But they're quick as Lee Johnson gets the roll.
Lee Johnson did not play a very good game last night against North Carolina Central. Scored but 4 points, and he's averaging 19.
Well, I think that you got to give a credit to the defense of North Carolina Central last night. But Lee, he's going to come back. He's an outstanding outside shooter and down in the hole.
You know, Virginia State had some of the same problems they're suffering right now against Union early in the game, in which they had the lid on the basket. They just couldn't get anything to fall.
Good example right there. Same thing for Norfolk State. They got it down.
They certainly did. And it was Jerome Coles getting the basket. And the Spartans get the lead, regain the lead, 10-9.
Well, this number, I tell you right now, Charlie, this little Chris Holloway sees all the court. He's getting that ball down on the inside to the people that can score.
Well, we saw him make a tremendous pass in a game last night against Virginia Union. A no-look pass after the ball was dumped into it. In fact, he was responsible, I would say, more or less for them winning, Greg, because he got the pass to Lamont Walker that enabled him. I mean, they had the ball with 6 seconds left and had to go 90 feet. And they got it all the way down the court with his help and pushed it up as Brian Price picks up his first personal.
Well, you know, it takes a great deal of maturity to be able to be aware of the clock. Of course, 6 seconds doesn't sound like a lot. And he made a key pass to Lamont last night so that he could nail that jumper. I think he's a fine player. I'm talking about Holloway.
Carlos Thomas, the sophomore from Washington, D.C. No. Yes. That's his first personal foul. Third team foul. But meanwhile, going to the free throw line is Lamont Walker for Virginia State. Walker, third leading scorer on this team. They have four players, Virginia State, scoring in double figures. The only one who is not is Chris Holloway among the starters, and he's averaging 8 points a game. Lamont Walker, 11.7. He's shooting 75% from the line throughout the season, and he makes one of two. And the score is 12-10, Virginia State.
Tell you one thing, Carlos Thomas made a mistake that time. He did not check anybody behind him, and he was running with his back to the ball. And you always should open up on the ball.
14:05, the time remaining in the first half. Carlos Thomas dumps it inside, and Lee Johnson had trouble controlling it.
Well, that time he was forcing the issue, too. Carlos Thomas trying to create something that obviously was not there.
For the basket, Chris Holloway.
Well, wait a minute. I think that was a left-handed shot by Chris Holloway on that layup.
That was a left-handed.
And they charged him with the offensive foul, but they give him the basket. And it's a four-point lead for Virginia State, their biggest lead of the night.
And the reason he was given that, he had shot the ball before he made contact.
Ball had left his hands.
And like you said, Sam, Stith has recovered. He's back in the game.
Oh, they need Stitt back in the game because he's one of the leaders out there. Even though he doesn't average in double figures, he adds so much to this team.
Eustace Jewell is in the lineup now, 00, and the reason that they call the timeout is because he's wearing a gold chain around his neck, and that's a no-no in college basketball. No jewelry.
I really thought that was a technical foul. I didn't know about this.
He's a freshman. We saw them against Virginia Union in the game that they won at Norfolk State. And Eustace Jewell had a whale of a ball game coming off the bench. Stiff, he's back in there, and Jewell can't control.
I tell you, these turnovers are going to hurt Norfolk State if they keep missing down that low.
How about that pass?
Oh, yes.
I tell you, you gotta like him. Sam, you know, Holloway.
Look at this pass.
As we see this tremendous left-handed pass, mind you, underneath the...
I think it's Wallace.
Yeah. You know, they list Holloway in the program as a freshman, but I'm sure you would agree, this late in the season, he's no longer a freshman. He's playing like a sophomore or maybe a junior.
You better believe it. He's playing great.
When you get to 30 games, you're not a freshman anymore. Walker. Yes.
Number 20, James Walker.
Six 16-12. Holloway, little skip to DeLu. Lamont Walker for three. Yes.
That's that number two guard, and he can shoot it, the same kid who shot it last night.
He had it in the right hands, didn't he? 12:40, the time remaining in the first half. 19-12 the score. Won't fall. Eustace Jewell is there for the tip-in.
Eustace Jewell from the U.S. Virgin Islands. I tell you, you can go down there and find some pretty good basketball players.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter if you don't stop it at the other end.
Got to play some defense on the other end, and Holloway came right down with the three-pointer.
21-14 is the score. Under 12 minutes to go first half. CIAA basketball tournament action at its best. Lamont Walker will pick up the personal foul. It is his first. An 8-point lead now. It's 22-14, rather.
Now we're talking about the Virgin Islands producing some pretty good basketball players. I say that because at Michigan State, I was fortunate to have a guy from the Virgin Islands on my team, Ron Charles, who did a sensational job for us.
He certainly did.
Yeah, go down there and steal a few. Sam, you mentioned the height of the Virginia State guards and how Norfolk State should take advantage of the mismatches, but over the season, I've seen Norfolk State. They don't have a lot of players where they go down low to their guards. So right now, I don't think that's a mismatch that they'll be able to exploit.
But I sure would try it when you got kids in there that are big.
Yeah.
And timeout, 11:55 remaining first half. 22-16 is the score. The Trojans leading the Charlie Neal, Sam Jones, Greg Kelser, and there's what's happened so far in the game as far as the two schools are concerned. In field goal percentage so far in the first half, 56% for Virginia State, 58% for Norfolk State.
Pretty even the percentages. The difference right now is turnovers. Norfolk State is committing more right now.
This is Lamont Walker, swinging it left. He gets out of there.
And got a shot.
They blew it. That was Dwayne Ellis, number 22, the senior from Dinwiddie, Virginia. Now the turnover, Antonio Stith working against Dwayne Ellis. Underneath, there's a foul on double zero, Eustace Jewell.
Eustace not a small player at 215, but he's going against literally a strong man in Leonard Harris, number 34 from Virginia State.
They're both pretty good, big size, and you know, Jules is only a freshman, while Leonard Harris is a junior.
We'd like to say that Virginia State's women have won the women's championship. They beat Norfolk State's women. And we'd like to say congratulations to them and Dr. Leon Bay, who is going out as head coach after this year. He's going to retire after 8 years and just devote his time to being athletic director at Virginia State, and he already has his replacement pick.
And would that be his assistant coach?
Yes.
She's a good one.
What's her name, sir?
Bertha.
Cummings.
Right.
Bertha Cummings.
She was at UBC, by the way, as a head coach.
Mm-hmm. Cross court. Here's James Walker. Jumps it up. Off the mark. Follow up by Cole. 22-18.
And that was a mistake because when the ball is shot, someone has got to go and block out first before you go to the ball.
Especially against a player like Coles because he's going to the basket hard, the offensive area.
I thought that the mistake Blackwell made that time was he put the ball on the floor.
Well, he knows that
he gets the ball. Watch. Instead of going right up.
Well, it's a drop step. He's away from the basket, so he used a drop step, which is very good, and he did it the right way because he's got, look at that. He's got the ball between himself and the defensive man.
And notice he went up strong. He got hammered across the arm pretty good and still was able to get the shot off and get the foul.
15 fouls against the Spartans of Norfolk State. And at the free throw line, Blackwell against Norfolk State. The first time they met, he didn't even start that game, but he finished with 4 points, six rebounds in 23 minutes. In the second meeting, 18.7 rebounds, five blocks. And that was in 35 minutes of work. And it's 24-18 after he converts the free throws.
Well, to further embellish the effectiveness of Blackwell, I think we'd be a little bit remiss if we didn't talk about the defensive effort that he was able to come up with last night against Terry Davis, Mr. Everything down here in the CIAA.
You know what, we're looking at the guards are playing man-to-man, and the other guys are in a matchup zone.
Well, Virginia State is going to give you some different looks on defense. They switch up, and it's up to the offensive team to respond to the different defenses.
24-20 is the score. The lead has been cut. They've outscored Virginia State 6-2 over the last couple of moments after it was an 8-point lead. Harold Dean. And they turn it over on the line. 9:24 remaining. 4-point lead. Norfolk State can cut it to 2. They trail by as many as 8. There's Walker. He'll stop and pop. No good. Away. The little guy.
Little guy's always back. The big guy brought the ball down too low.
Oh, passed to the wrong man.
Holloway finally made a mistake, but that's right away. Virginia State gets the ball back.
He'll settle it down under 9 minutes to go in the half. Blackwell turns around, won't fall, and Coles has the rebound. Anthony Reed brings it up the court for Virginia. Make that Norfolk State. Traveling, stiff.
Yes.
And there's a timeout on the floor. 8:44, the time remaining. We're in the first half of play here from the Scope in Norfolk. It's the 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. Norfolk State trying to win another one. They've been here a lot of times. Charlie Neal, Sam Jones, Greg Kelsey with you here at the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia. Norfolk State came into the game ranked fifth. Make that tied for 12th in the nation in Division II, while North Carolina Central was ranked fifth, Virginia Union seventh. They've both been knocked out of the tournament. When you come to tournament time, look at the turnover situation. 3 for Virginia State, 9 for Norfolk State. But when you come to the tournament time, it's anybody's ball game.
It's wide open.
You know, that's the great thing about these tournaments. I bet you if you took a consensus or a check of all the tournaments across the country, you'd find that the majority of the time it's a team that's not expected to win it that usually wins. The number one, number two seed rarely wins.
That foul was on Jerome Garrett, number 32, his first 16 foul. So that next one against the Spartans will put them over the limit, and the Trojans will shoot the 1-1. Nice move, but it wouldn't fall for Price. .15 left. First half. Stiff. Out high. Reed trying to work loose underneath.
And surprisingly for Norfolk State, Lee Johnson, their leading scorer, has been on the bench for quite some while.
Off the mark. But look who goes down and gets his own pass.
Look at that pass.
Across court.
I don't know how he sees him.
I don't know if he saw him. I just think he looked for an open color, which is orange.
Way right across orange. The court. I mean, he shot it. He threw it over the basket. But he knew where. He has such great floor vision. Peripheral vision is fantastic. He sees everything.
There's you.
Coles.
That's where he's getting it. No one is blocking Coles out. They got to keep him off those boards.
Look at that pass through the hands of Leonard Harris.
You have to always have your eyes open.
I tell you, anybody, anytime that a guard who can pass a ball like that, you got to keep your eyes on the ball because he sees everything. That's a great pass. Right through his hands.
7 minutes, 20 seconds, the time remaining in the first half of play. Also in the lineup now is Guy Fauntleroy. We talked about him in the opening. There he is with the ball. Off the Eustace Jewell on a block, and they're going to call Lamont Walker for a foul. That is his second.
And that was a good move by Eustace Jewell because his man had to leave him to cover up, and he trailed him right in and got the pass, and now he's going to get fouled. Look at this.
You get a look at Fauntleroy making that good pass. He's being awarded with some early playing time tonight. Last night didn't get into the game until late, but was effective, very effective.
He reminds you so much when you just look at him real quickly of Ralph Talley. He has the same type of profile. In fact, Ralph Talley is here. Got a chance to talk to him. A lot of people are here. Always a lot of celebrities here at the CIAA tournament. Jim Bibby, I see Harold Jackson, that used to be the wide receiver for the Rams, is here. And Bob Lanier.
Cleo Hill.
Cleo Hill, his son, playing for North Carolina Central University.
Jamie Walla.
Former Virginia Union player.
Bobby Dandridge, sir.
Bobby Dandridge, assistant coach now with Hampton University.
You know,
Lou
you
Smith
mentioned
is here. Buffalo Bills.
Yeah.
He's from this area. Timmy Newsom plays with the Cowboys. And the list is on and on.
This is quite an event. We've talked about it before. You mentioned number 10, Fauntleroy, favoring Talley. I don't think that's a coincidence. He's got a Ralph Talley half haircut. He walks like Ralph Talley. He chews his gum like Talley.
Lamont Walker can't get it to fall, and Coles pulls. Credit that rebound rather to Jerome Garrett. Stiff, short jumper, and it's good. 1-point ball game, 26-25 with 6:37 remaining. It was a 4-point lead just a minute ago. They've cut it to one. They've trailed by as many as eight. Blackwell, Lamont Walker for three. No, off the back of the iron. 6:15 remaining first half. Here's Fauntleroy, short jumper. No. Battle for the loose ball, and Coles puts it in.
He's been omnipresent on the boards tonight. They have got to get somebody to block him out.
Forget about the ball. Every time the ball goes up, you got to go to Jerome Coles and keep him off the boards.
60-26, 27-26. Under 6 minutes to go in the first half. Wide open for the layup, Ryan Price. It's a back and forth ball game. Norfolk State beat Virginia State twice during the regular season.
Which means absolutely nothing. We've seen it before. It's very difficult to beat a team three times within one college season.
Antonio Stiff.
One thing I know about Stiff, he loves to go right and come back to his left and take that quick jump shot.
You're right, Sam. Rarely does he try and go all the way to the basket. He always pulls up wisely, middle of the key area, or maybe shorter on the baseline with his little jumper.
Brian Price. That foul was against Jerome Coles, number 42.
2 points good.
There he is. And at the free throw line, trying to complete the three-point play is David Blackwell. He was fouled on the shot, and he does. And we'll have a substitution for the Trojans of Virginia State in the form of Leonard Harris, number 34. He'll come in and give David Blackwell a break. So now it's a two-point ball game. Trojans back on top, 31-29, with 5:05 left in the first half.
Harris went out the game for a short period of time to maybe be settled down in the mind of his coach, Dean, over there. He hasn't scored. He hasn't got untracked yet, so maybe the rest will get him going.
Holloway. Reggie Blackwell with the basket.
I'll tell you one thing, Reggie stayed right with it. He got it blocked the first time, but got a goaltending on.
And look at this. You look at that. I know you can appreciate that. Anytime you get a guard on your team that can find you like that, I had the opportunity to have probably one of the best passers ever to play the game with me in Michigan State. I'm talking about Irvin Johnson, and certainly you benefited from a pretty good guard, Bob Cousy.
I call him magic.
Eustace Jewell. Very close to an offensive foul on that last basket because he dipped the shoulder when he went in there.
Did look like an offensive foul.
4:15 remaining, 33-31. 2-point lead for Virginia State. 4:10 and the clock running. A substitution, a couple of them will be coming in. The next dead ball we'll see Lee Johnson checking back in for Norfolk State. Meanwhile, shot clock down to 15 seconds, and now Virginia State spreading it out a little bit. Everett Watkins with the ball off to Leonard Harris. Harris trying to dump it inside. And they're going to call a foul. And they're going to call it on Guy Fauntleroy.
Oh, no way. Guy came. He didn't come across the top. It came from the side.
And they're in the bonus. So that puts Lamont Walker at the line for 1-1.
Watch this pass. Yep. He hits it. It's a good call.
From our angle at first, that was a better angle than we actually had.
Well, the official had that angle.
At first.
The official had the right angle.
Yeah,
right?
I was agreeing with you at first, Sam. I didn't think it was a foul, but the replay clearly showed it was.
Of course, Charlie Christian doesn't agree with the call. Lamont Walker runs it in. Walker, throughout the tournament, shooting 75% from the line. 78% throughout the year. And there's a timeout on the floor, and it's a four-point advantage right now, 35-31. We will take a timeout. So far, Sam, there have been six lead changes in the ball game. They're live from the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia. Charlie Neal, Sam Jones, and it looks like the cheerleaders are trying to outdo themselves in a dance contest here. Virginia State in their blue and white on the left side. Well, the crowd liked it, I'll tell you that.
Well, I'll tell you what, I give that round to Virginia State. There's that guy Holloway again, penetrating, dishing off.
He just runs right by people.
Yeah.
They get free, too.
3:39 remaining, first half. Fauntleroy over to James Walker. Stiff is also in the lineup along with Jerome Coles and Lee Johnson. Johnson has the ball. That's the lineup for Charlie Christian and the Norfolk State Spartans. Fauntleroy. And the basket is good. And we got a foul. It is not a shooting foul, so he will not go to the line. And it's not a 1-1. They're not in the bonus. But they will retain possession. And they've cut the lead to 35-33. 2 points
good. That hurts there, because now that gives you the opportunity, if you're Norfolk State, to get a four-point play out of one trip down the court, possibly five with a three-pointer.
That's right.
2-point advantage for Virginia State. Norfolk State with the ball right now. They just substituted. They brought in Everett Watkins to give Leonard Harris a break after he picked up his first personal foul. Walker, he'll take the three-pointer. No, it was a two-point attempt. Lamont Walker with the rebound. Here's Blackwell. Reggie. Yes.
Good move. 2 points.
Got a fine bounce there.
Took it right to Antonio Stitt that time.
So you got Reggie Blackwell, number 41 in the lineup. His brother David, number 33.
You know, I'm still impressed with Fauntleroy getting a lot of time.
That's why he's getting it. He showed he can play last night. Not a three-pointer. Two-point attempt. David Blackwell with the outlet pass to Chris Holloway.
That pass, I thought, was a little bit too hard. He's got to ease up on that pass. But he doesn't make too many mistakes.
Hope all our viewers enjoyed the Doug Williams special we showed earlier. Let's watch this pass. Talking about passing, it made me think of Doug Williams.
Yeah. Like Sam said, had to take a little bit off of it. But, again, you don't criticize him for that, because he's right more times than he's wrong.
Stiff in the corner. Walker, two-pointer, in and out. David Blackwell with the rebound. Here's Chris Holloway.
And you'll notice on that rebound, he had Coles blocked out well. They're doing a much better job on the boards.
Lamont Walker dumps it in to David Blackwell over to Holloway. Now they set it up. 1:40 remaining. First half, 37-33 Trojans. David Blackwell, turnaround.
Good.
Is good.
Move. He's turning around right in his face. And it's hard to block that shot, because you're afraid you might foul him.
You're right, it's impossible to block that shot without fouling, especially when he gets it so high up over his head like Blackwell does.
39-33, Virginia State, 6-point lead with a minute and 15 remaining in the first half.
Haven't heard much.
Pomeroy.
From Harris, from Lee. Well, you know, last night and today, tonight, Lee is not hungry on the offensive end.
Stiff.
He doesn't impress me as wanting the ball.
Nice pass.
That's offensive.
Offensive foul, though, against David Blackwell. It is his first. 47
no
seconds
question.
Remaining.
Replay will show it, too. Good drop-off pass that time from Black, from Harris to Blackwell, and he pushed off.
He did not have to push that time.
No.
He's going to get the foul, but he does use that left elbow, left arm.
Clinton Wright is in the lineup now, the freshman from Suffolk, Virginia, wearing number 40 for the Norfolk State Spartans.
And last night, Wright came off the bench, played 17 minutes, had 9 points and 3 rebounds, and did a fine job on the defensive end.
39-35, 17 seconds to go. Harold Dean, you just saw a shot of him. They'll play for the last shot. 9 seconds, 8. The shot clock is off. They dump it over. 3 seconds. They have to take it. And that'll be the end of the first half. But it's been a good one here. 39-35 is our halftime score. Stay with us. We got plenty for you at halftime. Slam dunk competition. We'll also have a talk with Harold Dean, the Virginia State.
You know who the best player in the game is? Me, Mars Blackman. And I'm way above the rim, demonstrating some serious hang time. Very serious. You know how I get up for my game? Do you know? Do you know? Do you know? That's right. Air Jordan, Air Jordan, Air Jordan. Mike, what's up? Oh, money. Why you want to do that to me? Why you leave me hanging? I got it. Oh, Mike, man. That's cold, man.
I'm not going to count on those other people. They may not have the shit.
Well, that looks good.
What's that guy's name from the Chicago Bulls?
AJ English, perfect dunk, 50.
Second time he's gotten a perfect 50. What's his name, Michael who? AJ English. So going into the third dunk. The third and final dunk, AJ English has the lead, followed by Stevens and Sewell. This is Stevens with 95 points.
He can replace it.
Throws it in reverse style. Stevens deciding to take the safer route. Scores 8-8, 7-8, 9 from the judges. 3-8, a 7, and a 9 for a total of 40.
This is Sewell, his third and final dunk. He has 91 points.
Rock the cradle with the reverse. Judges score 9. 4 9s and a 10. 46.
And that right now has him in second place with 137 total points. AJ English, our final competitor, his final dunk. He has 106 points. Make that 96 points before that dunk. And he gets
44,
which would give him 140 points. So the way it winds up is AJ English will win it with a total of 140 points. Sewell in second place with 137. And Stevens in third place, 135. We'll be back with the awards presentation of the Slam Dunk Competition, sponsored by Polaroid and BET.
This bug's for all that you do.
Papers say you busted it up pretty good. This is where we start.
You got a long road back. You missed the cheers. Can you beat those doubts and fears? You make America work.
For that something that won't let us quit, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
To your first game back.
This bug's for you.
Mars Blackman here again. You know, nobody in the world could cover my main man, Michael Jordan. Nobody, nobody, nobody. No, nobody. I'm telling you, it's impossible. 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 Impossible.
However, it's easy to cover Mars Blackman.
We on?
You don't mind it, yeah, now.
We're at halftime. We're back at halftime here at the 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. As you probably knew before the game, we had the slam dunk competition, and we'd like to make the award to all the participants, plus give the winners their trophies and plaques. And here to assist me, as you know, this contest is co-sponsored by Black Entertainment Television and Polaroid. And from Polaroid, to assist me with the checks, Linda DeLau, the winner's school will receive $1,500 and then go to the school's general scholarship fund. The second place participant will school will receive $1,000. The third place will receive $500 that will go to the school's general scholarship fund. Plus, the participants will receive trophies. Now first, we'd like to thank all of our contestants in this contest. And from Johnson C. Smith, Vincent Brown. He doesn't get a check. Black, black, black. James Ebron from Black Entertainment Television sales staff presenting the plaques. Also, Kevin Reed from Winston-Salem State University. Cletus Dalton from St. Paul's College. And on behalf of BET and Polaroid, we'd like to thank you for participating. Now for the runner-ups. Our second runner-up with a total of 136 points, from North Carolina Central University, Dominique Stevens. $500 check goes to Dominique Stevens in the name of North Carolina Central University's General Scholarship Fund. Congratulations, and here's your trophy, Dominique. Our first runner-up from Bowie State College, with a total of 137 points, Vincent Sewell. Sewell will receive, along with the young man from North Carolina Central, also a Spectrum camera from Polaroid, this check for $1,000 plus a trophy. Congratulations. And the winner from Virginia Union University. Not only does he get a camera,
trophy for winning the slam dunk contest. Congratulations to AJ England. Don't forget the check, AJ. The real one. We'd like to thank all our participants. Congratulations. And we'll be back with more in just a moment. Thank you.
This week's Coach's Corner is being brought to you by the U.S. Navy. We invite you to learn the technology of tomorrow in the Navy of today.
Each week at halftime, BET brings you Coach's Corner. Hello, I'm Sam Jones, and with me tonight, the successful coach of the Virginia State University, Harold Dean. And Dean, it's been 8 years since you've coached, and you're coaching your same school right now. Are you much wiser?
I am, because I officiated basketball for 8 years and learned about the rules and regulations associated with the game. And I think a lot of coaches need to go through that particular channel in order to establish a basis which to make decisions on and use fundamentals for. So I'm glad that I did that, and now I feel like I'm well learned, and I still have a lot to learn. We all do, but I think I know a little bit more about the game and how to relate it to the fundamentals and to the rules of the game.
In watching your game last night, you seem to stay on your point guard, number 10, out on the floor. He seems to be your catalyst. He's your second coach on the floor. And I noticed that you call a timeout within 2 minutes into the ball game, and usually coaches don't do that. What did you have to say to him and your team at that moment?
Well, I try to give him some confidence because he's a freshman. And very seldom does a 5'7 freshman come in and run your offense the way this young man is doing. I think he's doing a tremendous job. He just played great mental toughness. Sometimes he gets hard on himself, gets down on himself. And I try to give him words of encouragement, tell him that he could do it. Yeah, but I don't want you to think that I have to encourage this young man because he has it inside, intrinsically.
I think it's great that you can put that type of confidence in a freshman, because usually you don't like for them to start off playing in a game such as this. And I know that he's had the experience of some 20-some games that probably you have started him. I like to say that you played Virginia Union twice. They beat you twice. And all of a sudden, you're coming into the CIAA, which is one of the greatest, with 11,000 people here last night. What did you tell your team in playing Virginia Union?
Well, we told them, like we tell them about any other team, that you win the game with fundamentals. Strategists don't win basketball games. It's the fundamentals. And it depends upon your desire and your teamwork and team play. Defense, of course, and boxing out, they win the ball game. The game was decided by a last-second shot, however. However, that young man that made that shot did a tremendous job on the defensive end. So they only saw the shot that he made, but we played defense against Virginia Union, and we battled them on the backboards.
I tell you right now, Coach Dean, I'm impressed with the team that you have on this floor, and I'm also impressed with a young man by the name of Leonard Harris, who is a junior, and I feel that when I look at him play, I think about a Len Bias, who was drafted by the Celtics, and I think this man has the same potential that a Leonard Bias has.
Leonard Harris is tremendous. He has compensated for us this year by playing inside. And, of course, he's a nice forward. He could shoot outside, but he's taking his game inside so the team can win.
All right, we've been talking to Coach Harold Dean, playing in the finals tonight. This is Sam Jones. Back to you, Charlie.
This week's coach.
39-35 is our halftime score. Virginia State leading Norfolk State at halftime. And as you know, there's a lot of players who have played here in the CIAA who are now making their living or have made their living playing in the National Basketball Association. Guys like Earl Monroe, Rick Mahorn, Charles Oakley, even the guy sitting next to me, Sam Jones.
And the guy
we put together a little tribute to honor these players. We'll be right back. was that guy? With those old high-top shoes on. you know, those high-tops are back, aren't they?
Not only that, I saw some...
They never left Boston.
I saw some black and white pictures there. The rest of the guys had color.
Sam, I saw you lay it up a couple times. You ever dunk in the NBA?
No, I didn't. Hey, I didn't want to show off.
You didn't want to show off?
No.
Let me move this advertisement out of the way. All this free advertisement they're getting here.
You know, Greg, I must say that when you fellas came along, you had better equipment to work with, things that we could not use when we played basketball because people thought it was bad to use weights and that type of stuff.
I'll tell you what, Sam, I'll trade all that stuff for about a couple of championship rings, huh?
Well, Greg, I got a few that you can borrow if you give them back.
You have four, right?
I have 10.
What is your fondest memory of playing in the CIAA?
My fondest memory? Well, I didn't have too many fond memories, but the one thing that I really liked was going to the CIAA like this, what we call the championship rounds. We could never get by more than the second round. And I remember vividly, I think the last time that Central won was 1951, and we were talking about that. And looked like last night they may get here, but they were upset by Norfolk State.
I know you were rooting for them. 39-35 is our halftime score here. Virginia State is leading by 4 points, and we'll be back with more halftime activity in the second half of tonight's contest. In a moment, we're live from the Scope in Norfolk. 39-35, we're at halftime here. 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. When you look at the first half, of course, it was a back-and-forth game. Quite a few lead changes, at least 9. It was Virginia State going out in front, then Norfolk State coming back, making a game out of it. But let's look at some of the stats from the first half and see how these two teams have matched up and maybe talk about a little bit about what they're going to have to do in the second half. Of course, the field goal percentage, the Spartans are leading in that department, 53% to 48%. Free throws, they have 7 of 9, the Spartans 3 of 4. So they've only missed 1 free throw.
Key stat here, Charlie, is the rebounds, 21 for the Spartans, 11 for the Trojans. A lot on the offensive end for the Spartans, particularly Jerome Coles.
I think they adjusted later on in the first half because of the fact Jerome Coles was getting blocked out more often to keep him off those boards, and that was a great adjustment for the Trojans.
A necessary adjustment, if you will.
You know, we talk about MVPs and things that have happened over the years in the CIAA tournament as we look at those statistics there. One of the things is the MVP. This is a tournament that's in its 43rd year. The first year was 1946. It was Virginia State, and they were playing North Carolina College, which is now known as North Carolina Central. I had an opportunity this week to speak to the first ever CIAA MVP way back to 1946.
Who would you compare yourself to some of these players out here? Who would you get more like the guys we're seeing out here?
I saw a young man from, I think it's Johnson C. Smith.
Vincent Brown.
Vincent Brown, number 10. I thought he did an outstanding job in directing the team. He was a great ball handler. Unfortunately, his team lost today. And I think had he taken a shot or had enough forewarning about the 5 seconds left in the game, they might have been able to pull it out or pull out a tie.
Well, how do you compare the game of the day with when you played?
Well, the game of today is much faster. I think when we played a more deliberate game. There's more emotion in what I'm seeing today in the games than we had at that time. Of course, there's a lot of stress at that time also. But the players are very, very intense about playing the game and getting as many points as possible. But I think that those things will nurture in those young ball players, and soon, after a year or two, they'll develop and have a discipline that will take them through life and make great successes of them.
Thank you.
All right.
Good luck. Okay, James Killer Dilworth. The nickname was Killer, and as you heard him say, Sam, he said the young man from Johnson C. Smith, Vincent Brown, reminded him so much of himself.
Well, Vincent Brown is a very, very good player, very smart ball player. They listed him as a forward, yet I believe that he will make a guard in the NBA, either number 1 or number 2, because he has a good outside shot.
Okay, let's look at some highlights from the first half. Of course, we've talked about Chris Holloway and what he's been able to do. He's such a fantastic ball player, and he does such a good job of getting the ball to the open man. Here he is working. He had 5 points in the first half, but a number of assists.
I tell you, every forward, every center should be blessed to have a guard like this on their team that can really see him. I tell you, if you move without the ball, you're going to be the benefactor of some great passes.
That was a pass I could not understand at all, but very effective.
Here's your guy, Antonio Stiff, doing what he does best, penetrating, and like I said before, has a presence of mind. We didn't see it there, but he likes to pull up to take that short jumper, which he can nail.
A couple of things. Before we get back to this game strategy, what did you think of the slam dunk contest?
Well, Charlie, Sam and I were commenting on it. I thought that there were probably some players that weren't in it that probably could have made it a little better, but for the first year, I certainly think it was a success.
I think it's going to get better. The only thing that we miss here is that we don't have the opportunity to use the players, you know, like playing tonight that's in the finals, that would have a chance to do something for their school.
Unfortunately, we had alternates for that reason, because we just felt that a coach would not allow his player, if they're playing in a championship game, to participate in the slam dunk contest, which you can understand that, because it's a possibility that a player could get hurt. All in all, very happy with it, and we're hoping to do it each and every year. We'll be back with more. The second half will be getting underway momentarily. Trojans leading the Spartans by four.
Yeah, I know that Ford Taurus has a very contemporary design. In fact, I really like the way it looks.
But looks aren't everything.
Check it out for yourself.
So, what do you think?
I'll let you know in a couple of hundred miles.
Now, during Ford's leadership celebration, get a $750 cash bonus on Taurus.
You know who the best player in the game is? Me, Mars Blackman. And I'm way above the rim, demonstrate some serious hang time. Very serious. You know how I get up for my game? Do you know? That's right. Air Jordan. Mike, what's up? Oh, money. Why you want to do that to me? Why you leave me hanging? I got it. Oh, Mike, man. That's cold, man.
Charlie Neal, along with Sam Jones and Greg Kelser, live at the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia, where our halftime score is 39-35. We looked at some of the stats from the first half. Let's look at the leading scorers in the first half of tonight's ball game. First of all, for the Norfolk State Spartans, you have Jerome Toles with 10 points, followed by Antonio Stiff with 8. James Walker has 6 points. Eustace Jules with 5. And Guy Fauntleroy with 2 points apiece. While Virginia State's leading scorer, David Blackwell with 12, followed by Brian Price with 8. Chris Holloway with 5. Lamont Walker with 6. Everett Watkins with 4. And Reggie Blackwell with 4. Charlie Christian, you're looking at him. He's a story in himself. He's been here twice, just like Harold Dean. A lot of similarities in these coaches. Charlie Christian is in his 12th year. He was the head coach of the Spartans from 73 to 78, then came back in 81. And he's the fourth winningest active coach in Division II. And as we start the second half, it'll be Virginia State's ball. They'll inbound and they'll control. They lead 39-35 as we start the second half here from the Scope in Norfolk, Virginia, 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. 2 years ago, or for the last 2 years, it has been in Richmond, Virginia. And they came back here this year. Tough shot. It will not fall for Dwayne Ellis, who is starting the second half for Virginia State. He did not start the ball game, but he is starting in place of Lamont. No, he's not starting in place of Lamont Walker. Starting in place of Brian Price.
Anthony Reed.
Well, Anthony Reed makes it a 39-37 ball game.
Well,
Reed is
watch,
starting the second half.
I want to watch Lee Johnson for Norfolk State in the early going to see if he starts begging for the basketball. I know he's a player that can score points, but to me, he has not shown the offensive attitude that you got to have to be a consistent scorer.
That's who I want to see shoot. That's Leonard Harris, Charlie. And that's his first point.
2 points.
Leonard Harris finally getting on the scoreboard.
Well, Leonard Harris can score points in bunches. Last night, it took him about 4 minutes to get his first basket, and then he got six real quick, six baskets, I'm saying.
He really got hot, didn't he?
He did.
Jerome Coles makes it 41-39.
Look at
that pass again.
Underneath, Leonard Harris. There you go, Greg. He must have heard you.
Greg, I don't know how that got through. It went through two defensive people.
You know, the thing, too, we talk about the offensive players that play alongside Holloway moving and just keeping their eye open, and they'll get a good pass. The defensive players, it puts a lot of pressure on you when you got a guy who can find people like that.
Charlie Christian not happy along the sideline. He's getting ready to make a substitution. He wants to send Clinton Wright into the lineup. There he is, number 40.
You know,
be checking in.
In the days of 6'9" and 6'10" point guards.
Wayne Ellis with the steal, and it's 45-39.
I was saying, in a day and age when you see a lot of 6'8", 6'9" point guards, it's still refreshing to see that there's still room for a 5'9", 5'10" guy in basketball.
That's right. Especially well, you got the Bogues, and you got the guy down in Atlanta, so there's room for the small guy. Especially if he can make something happen like that.
Hey, yeah, see, you know, on that penetration, they were looking for him, Holloway,
to drop it off.
That's right, to drop it off.
Charlie Christian wants to slow this thing down before it becomes a runaway freight train. 8-point lead right now, which equals their biggest lead of the night. The last time they led that by that many was 22-14 in the first half. You know that fella there?
Bigfoot.
Bigfoot.
Sam, he's going to kill you. He's going to get you for that.
He's here in attendance, former Milwaukee Buck, and also former president of the Players Association.
That's right, the NBA Players Association.
Right. And doing a very good job with the Thurgood Marshall Foundation.
Which supports the 35 state-supported black colleges.
Yes, indeed. And he's been a very instrumental spokesman for them. 17-18 remaining in the regulation here. Carlos. And finally we get a foul underneath. It's going to go against David Blackwell. And that will send, that's his second. That'll send Jerome Coles to the line.
Sam, you mentioned the adjustment that Virginia State made on this guy Coles in the late in the first half. Well, apparently they forgot what they did because he's back on the boards and doing damage.
I credited the foul to David Blackwell. They gave that foul to 22, Dwayne Ellis. Meanwhile, at the free throw line is Jerome Coles. First shot in and out. Coles was the leading scorer for the Spartans in the first half with 10 points, 47-39, and that's what he's done throughout the season.
And he got most of those off the offensive boards.
That's a travel.
Oh, they got it, a good call.
Blackwell traveling. 47-40 is the score. Virginia State came into the contest averaging 89 points a ball game. Norfolk State 73.5 points a game. Right.
There they come. Watch him.
4-on-3. No good. And that foul will be charged against Clinton Wright. Number 40. Team first in the second half, and his first.
47-40 is the score.
You look at Holloway pulling up for that jumper. Some would think it would be ill-advised, but they had numbers, so the offensive rebound would probably be claimed by Virginia State, and it was.
That's right.
Leonard Harris. And we're going to get an over-the-back foul charged against Dwayne Ellis. It'll be the second team foul, his second.
Fouls number 22, Dwayne Ellis, his second team foul.
Norfolk State ball. Ellis out of Dinwiddie, Virginia, senior.
They got to be careful. He just picked up his second foul.
Who is that, Holloway?
No, number 22.
That's his third.
Well, talking to Wallace Dooley, the sports information director from Virginia State this morning, we talked about Ellis. He was saying that he's a leaper, a guy with real quick hands that can play the small forward position, but sometimes gets himself into trouble with the silly fouls.
Brian Price has checked into the lineup to replace him, number 42. 6'15 remaining in the regulation here. 47-40 is our score. And the long jumper by Walker is good for two. 47-42. Holloway. Just think, a lot of coaches are hoping that Holloway was a senior. They have to contend with him for three more years.
You better believe it.
And you know he's going to improve.
And Wright will pick up a foul. Clinton Wright, his second.
Fouls on number 40, Clinton Wright, his second.
Wright's got a tough job if he's got to try to stop Leonard Harris down low.
Leonard, a very impressive young man, right, Greg?
Yes, and the thing that impressed me most is the fact that he's very intelligent, very articulate young man, very mannerable. I really like him. And he's a darn good basketball player.
that doesn't hurt, does it?
I really like the way David Blackwell turns and posts, because he turns right into man's face, which makes it pretty hard.
Here's Holloway.
And right on key, going up, getting that strong rebound. There's your guy, Sam.
Oh, yes. And you know... on this play, as soon as he comes back, if you notice, it's Holloway. Watch this spin around now. He sees the open man. Nice, easy pass that time rather than that hard pass. And now I got a chance for a three-point play.
And the foul was charged to number 22.
Good fake.
Right there.
Well, you know, the mark of a real good point guard is a guy that can get the ball to people where they're most effective. And Holloway does a real good job at that. Harris does a good job of getting in position.
And look at that block.
Oh, yes.
By David Blackwell.
Blackwell is turned on. I tell you, he's playing all phases of the game right now. Penetration by Stith. This time, instead of pulling up, decides to go in and gets it swatted away.
That's his 70th block of the year, the 11th of the tournament. 15:05 remaining in regulation. 8-point lead by the Trojans. But Anthony Reed picks up two more for the Spartans. 50-44. A lot of time, 14:50. Norfolk State's last lead.
That's where you want it, right there.
27-26.
And see, the thing about the difference between him and Lee Johnson, talking about Blackwell is hungry for the ball. He wants it. He demands it. And he's very effective on the inside. Lee Johnson does not do that.
Well, there's James Walker heating up.
Another thing, if you work for the ball, you'll get the ball. Lee is not working hard enough. And you know, he's not even in the game.
He spent a large portion of this game on the bench.
Well, he made something happen as far as the excitement in the crowd. But there's a travel. Some of the crowd on hand, it's been sold out, as the tournament is always sold out.
Well, again,
he didn't know what to do with it.
Defensive pressure by Holloway. He's so diminutive, and he just causes problems for the bigger guards.
He surely does.
I'd like to say hello to Lula and all the folks down in Texas tonight. We saw some of their friends sitting up in the stands watching us on TV.
Leonard Harris may made that play by staying with the ball and knocking it out the defensive man's hands.
8-point advantage by the Spartans, make that the Trojans with 13:30 left. And you saw the agony on the face of Charlie Christian.
I tell you, he frightens me. He gets upset, he has the toothpick in his mouth. I'm so afraid he's gonna swallow the thing, but he never does.
No, he has control. Let's watch the replay of this foul by Blackwell.
That's a good pass by Reed and going in deep to Cole, see? And that's what you got to do. You got to penetrate.
Well, Cole's demonstrating his strength on underneath. Goes up, gets hammered pretty good, and still makes the basket. 3-point opportunity.
Blackwell's got to learn when you foul, you're going to make surely that he doesn't make it and get a 3-point opportunity.
It's got to be a tough foul.
Lead
gotta
is be, cut
gotta
to
crush him.
54-49, 13:15 left in regulation. Holloway penetrating, has it stripped away. Here's Fauntleroy. Fauntleroy working against offensive foul.
And that's a good point.
You know, I agree with Charlie. He looks like Tally running down the floor. And Tally last year, how many times have we seen him? When he gets right here, he would have stopped, pulled up for the short jumper. And that's the difference between Tally and Fauntleroy right now. Fauntleroy made the wrong choice.
He certainly did. If you didn't know Tally had graduated.
It looked just alike.
It's unbelievable.
They could be brothers. In fact, is that Tally's number he's wearing?
I think he's wearing Tally's number. I told you it was not coincidence.
He's wearing Tally's number.
And he's quick.
Maybe a little taller than Tally. 54-49, 3-point attempt in and out.
Look at this. No one blocked out.
But Ryan Price converts the missed basket.
That's a mistake. Everybody's looking for someone to rebound, and nobody goes and get the ball.
Corner. Walker can't get it. Leonard Harris is running.
This ought to be exciting.
Yes.
Lamont Walker blew it. But he dumped it off to him. All he had to do was lay it in there. And it would have been a 9-point lead. It would have been their biggest lead of the night. Fauntleroy misses. Leonard Harris. He's going to try it again. Maybe an alley-oop.
Going all the way.
And he is fouled by Fauntleroy. Here's the most exciting player maybe in the CIAA.
Well, we're talking about
Chris Holloway.
We're talking about a freshman. And like you say, he's played 30-some ball games, so he's now let's call him an advanced freshman.
Next week, we may see a repeat of the same thing. We go down to the SWAC tournament. Southern University has a guard down there by the name of Avery Johnson, who's leading the nation in assists. And these two players, I'd like to see, put them on the same team. What would you have?
Well, we just have a lightning blur.
You'd have some very happy forwards and centers.
You certainly would. And you'd have some people running fast to get down in position.
Oh, yeah. Talk about Avery Johnson. He reminds you of Holloway. He's a lefty also. Passes the ball very well.
He makes one of two, 57-49. You know, Lamont Walker missed that easy layup down there. He's only 1 for 9 in this game in field goals.
Uh-oh.
Almost blew that. Price. Harris picks up a foul. His second.
Give the foul to Harris, but I tell you what, he's playing much more enthused, much more physical here in the second half.
He certainly is.
Timeout on the floor, 11:23 remaining. 57-49 the score. Trojans still hanging on tough, and they're on top right now. 57-49. 11:23 remaining. We're live from the Scope in Norfolk. This is the championship game of the 43rd annual CIAA basketball tournament. 11:15 the time remaining. The clock running. 57-49 Virginia State. They led at halftime, 39-35. Have not trailed since the 6:07 mark of the first half. There's Coles.
You know, when you penetrate, you draw that defense a man to you. And that was a good play.
Heads up. Goaltending.
Yes.
They caught it. Good call.
59-51. Charlie Christian, he doesn't think it was goaltending, I don't believe, but it's not going to change things.
No, it was really goaltending. Jerome Coles hit it as it was on the glass.
Number 35 for Norfolk State, Carlos Thomas. I look for him to be more aggressive in this tournament, but so far he has failed to respond.
Well, he's just going to play his part. He's going to be a defensive player, try to keep people from scoring, get the ball into the right hands.
Lee Johnson with that last basket. He's a young man that transferred a couple of years ago from Miami-Dade Community College. Didn't even play organized ball till his senior year of high school. So he's still developing and still learning.
They're going to sit on a while and rest some people.
Down to the 10-minute mark. We're midway through the second half. And a foul will be whistled against James Walker. His second.
Sam, did you see the two Norfolk State players battling inside, elbowing each other that time?
The players from the same team?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I guess they thought it was somebody else, huh?
They did. And we're not going to see it on this replay, but Jerome Coles was really giving it to Antonio Stith that time. Teammates.
But something to turn around and start hitting each other.
Well, it's like, get out of the way.
9:45 is the time remaining. 6-point lead for the Trojans of Virginia State. They're looking for a sweep here. The women have already won the women's title for the tournament. Now the men are looking for a title.
And they're being very patient on the offensive end. Shot clock nearing the 10-point mark, 10-second mark here.
That's a good move again. That's where they want to get it. And they're very patient and working to get what they need to get, and that is a good shot.
8-point advantage for the Trojans, 61-53. 9:05 at the time remaining. Blackwell, the leading scorer for the Trojans right now with 14 points. Nice move, but it wouldn't fall, and Blackwell gets the rebound, and the foul is going to go against Carlos Thomas. And they'll shoot the 1-1. And now they're in the penalty.
Right now for Norfolk State, and really throughout this game, the only player for them on the front court, on the front line that has been aggressive is Jerome Coles, whereas Virginia State is getting it from a variety of sources. Blackwell, Harris.
You know, they got to continue. I think what Norfolk State's got to do now is start going down low to Jerome, trying to get that ball in his hands.
Not only him, but Lee Johnson also.
Well, Lee's got to want it.
Walker grabs the rebound for the Spartans. Here's Anthony Reed. Take that Carlos Thomas, 35 with it. Stith pulls up in the lane. Good.
What Stith does best, penetrate, pull up for the short jumper.
6-point advantage, 61-55. Lamont Walker with a 3-point attempt. Then we're going to get a foul, and it's going to be whistled against Carlos Thomas. And going to the free throw line will be Lamont Walker. That's the third foul against Carlos Thomas.
Truly,
substitution in the lineup for Chris Holloway right now is Dwayne Ellis for Virginia State. Walker has not done well from the field. 1-for-9. And you see, he normally shoots 46%. He's only shooting 11% tonight. And he just misses the front end of a 1-and-1. The man who was the hero last night is having his problems tonight.
Sometimes they shoot better from the field than they do from the free throw line.
But he
line.
Hasn't shot well from the field. He's only 1-for-9 from the field. Stiff. Blackwell cleans the boards. Chairman of the board so far now that the offensive defensive end.
Gordon Christian, he's absolutely livid over there on that Norfolk State bench. He's wondering, what do we have to do to get a break here?
Well, he likes to demonstrate a little bit, too.
Trying to sway the officials, and sometimes it helps.
7:52 left in regulation. 5-point lead, 6-point advantage, 61-55. Trojans. Neil, Sam Jones, Greg Kelser. It's 7:52, the time remaining in regulation, 61-55. Trojans of Virginia State leading the Spartans of Norfolk State at the CIAA tournament. Let's look at some of the leading scores in the contest so far. As you look at Charlie Christian, Blackwell 14 points, Price with 12 for Virginia State, Coles with 18, and Antonio Stiff with 10 for the Spartans of Norfolk State. And Virginia State with the ball right now. This is Chris Holloway. Gets it back out to Dwayne Ellis. And look who's playing way out away from the basket, David Blackwell.
Well, they're using the clock, Virginia State, right now, and in no hurry to force the issue. They're ahead.
That's right. You know, they've taken Lee Johnson out because Lee doesn't like to come out and press.
Blackwell with a bad shot there. Didn't get it. He wanted a foul.
He's still looking at Jim Birch like the man got him on the arm.
Stiff. Good drive to the basket by
Reeves.
Anthony Reeves. The lead is cut to 4.
You know, you got to get Blackwell, David Blackwell, down in deeper now where he's more effective rather than bringing him out.
I agree with you. They've got to push that ball, pound that ball down in low to Blackwell and Harris. That's where their strength is. That's what they've been successful doing here in the second half, particularly.
Blackwell is complaining that he's being held by Coles everywhere he goes. Coles. Look at the battle inside between Wright and Leonard Harris. Ellis.
Oh, did he get the bounce?
He certainly did.
Got a very kind bounce because that was not the best shot, I don't think.
No.
Wide open. Foul will go against Leonard Harris. That is his third. 6:04, the time remaining. Blackwell will come out of the lineup and take a breather.
What do you think, Sam? I don't think this would have been a tough shot. I don't think the foul was necessary.
No, it wasn't, but you know, we always try to block those shots and commit that foul. And a lot of times they go in looking for the foul and you just fake at them, they're gonna miss it.
Right.
Everett Watkins, meanwhile, is checked in at the free throw line as Anthony Reed. That's what he's done today. So he's above his season average. Averaging just under 5 points a game during the regular season. Has 7 tonight.
Some players perform better in the playoffs than they do in regular season.
Did your game change that much in playoff competition?
A lot. My average went way up.
What are you saying?
I shot better, I guess.
You're a pressure player, right?
I don't know.
63-58. 5:40 remaining. 5:45 in regulation. They're all not only trying to run the clock down. Ellis. Ellis. 65-58. Under 5.5 to go. 7-point lead. Walker dumps it off to Coles for 2.
Okay, Coles is the beneficiary of some nice drop-offs from Antonio Stiff.
Because of the penetration by Stiff, make the defensive man commit himself, drops it off, an easy layup.
Virginia State again content to use the clock. They're playing.
There he goes.
And Stiff will pick up a personal foul.
I don't know, Greg.
First.
What do you think about that? What do you think about when they reach from behind once the man get by you? Especially in college.
That means you've been beat. If you're not moving your feet and your man has lost you, and this is like a last gasp effort.
Oh,
you see there. to try and make up for poor defensive play.
I think I would just holler help.
Well, you know, Sam, you had Bill Russell playing behind you. You could holler help.
I did.
Many a day, huh?
Many times.
Ellis has been shooting 71% from the line throughout the tournament. Through the season, same thing, so he's been consistent. And he sinks the front end of this 1-1. Here's the second, and it's good. So the lead is 7 once again, 67-60, with 4:52 remaining.
And it's getting to be crunch time.
You're absolutely right. We're down under 5.
But you can't have the senseless fouls. That's going to put Norfolk State at the free throw line. Lamont Walker, and going to line after he picks up his third personal foul, will be Anthony Reed.
I think what you got to do now, I think Norfolk State should just try to press something they haven't done, and they recovered on Central in the semifinals by pressing, so they should show it, and if they can't do it, back off.
Reed, a 71% free throw shooter throughout the tournament, throughout the year, overall 67%. 4:47 remaining, 7-point advantage.
Thing for Norfolk State, Virginia State, you don't want to stop the clock here and put Norfolk State on the line and let them get easy free throws. You want to make them work for their hoops and use the clock, keep it
that's
running.
That's right. You're just...
But that's easier said than done. But we're sitting here not out on the floor in the heat of the battle. Your whole thing is to stop the ball when you're on defense. 67-62.
Sam, there's that press you talked about.
That's a foul. They're going to call it a charge.
And the press was effective because it created disarray on the part of the Virginia State Trojans. The turnover, and now it's Norfolk going back. They can cut the lead to 3 points.
And you see Walker picks up his fourth personal foul. He's coming out.
Number 41.
Reggie Blackwell.
Reggie Blackwell. Replaces number 11, Lamont Walker.
Reggie Blackwell checks in as you look at Lamont on the bench with 4 fouls.
Well, with Blackwell, they don't lose any quickness. They don't lose any quickness with Blackwell. At the same time, they add a little bit more height.
Foul is on number 10, Chris Holloway.
See, again, those are the type of senseless fouls you're talking about. And they make these.
The Trojans are over the limit.
They're in within 3.
Well, I think Holloway that time was really making an effort to get out of the way.
Well, the crowd has been aroused, and it was not by what was happening on the floor, but by the man with the white suit and the pink hat on in the stands.
and the Aqua King.
Steph misses the front end of the 2-shot foul. He makes 1 of 2. 67-63. It's a 4-point ball game. 4:28 is the time. There he is. That's the man we're talking about. Aqua Kane, pink hat, white suit. We'll be back. They have it all here in Norfolk. Charlie Neal, Sam Jones, Greg Kelsa. What's the strategy for both teams now, gentlemen?
Well, if I'm Norfolk State, the idea, they're only down by 4 points. The idea is to do it with the defense. Don't foul. The clock is not so important anymore now that you're down by 4 points. Hit the boards after you force them into a bad shot, if possible, and then come down and exercise good offensive execution.
And if I'm Virginia State, I want to put Blackwell down low. I want to waste some time on the clock. And after wasting that time, I want to hit him real low. Right.
That's the other Blackwell. That's Reggie. That had the ball 41. So you're talking about David, 33.
I'm talking about David Blackwell, who has been so effective down low.
Leonard Harris. Trying to double-team him. And they're going to get a foul on Anthony Reed. And they're going to go to the line with 4:01 remaining.
And see, that's what I was talking about right there. You make them use 27 seconds of the shot clock, and then you see the drive here, and Reed bumps.
Number 22,
almost gets away with
Ellis.
It.
Bumps Ellis there, and Ellis was heading into trouble.
The dude was
let him go. But now he's on the line, and he can shoot the two free throws and build the lead back up to 5 points.
So Carlos Thomas comes in, and Anthony Reed goes to the bench. 1-1 situation for Dwayne Ellis. First one is good. The lead is 5. Ellis from Dinwiddie, Virginia. He's a senior. This is the second, though. That could be the crucial thing here, as you mentioned earlier, Sam.
Oh, yes. But with the three-point play, it's so easy to get back. And that's one right there, Charlie. He tried it. He brought it down, put it down where the guards are, rather than shooting the ball.
Oh, and I'm telling you, being a big guy who had the rebound, Sam, that used to upset me to no end. When you work real hard, get that rebound and have one of those little guards slip it out of your hand.
That's all he's got to do. Brought it down below his waist, and the guards stripped him.
Right. Picks up his third foul. And Holloway goes to the free throw line. And he'll shoot the 1-1. Now, Holloway, as I mentioned, is not the leading scorer, one of the leading scorers. He's the assist man on the team, but he's shooting 83% from the line through the tournament. And for the year, Holloway is shooting 65%. And he misses the front end.
And it's right now it's hurting Virginia State, because they could have had at least an 8 or 9 point lead could they hit the front end of the free throws.
Stiff. Battling for the rebound. Goes up again and loses it. Off a cold.
That's a good point you just made, Sam, because when you go to the free throw line and you miss the front end of a 1-1, that's just like missing two.
That's right.
Lamont Walker in for Reggie Blackwell, and the foul is going to be called on Antonio Stiff.
Of course, Norfolk State, they're not helping their cause right now.
No, but the thing is, Virginia State is not helping the cause either, because of all the opportunities that they've had at the free throw line, they have not taken advantage of them.
So then it's a standoff. Somebody, if they don't score, and somebody else score, it's a standoff.
Okay. Well, he makes this one after the last time when he went to the line having a problem. The second one is good. 70-63. The lead is 7.
Big free throws, Greg.
Yeah, he knocked 2 down, and the lead is 7.
Oh, they're going for the three-pointers, and that'll get them back in the game.
Well, that can get you back into it very, very quickly. Now for Norfolk State, the idea is to not foul. Not foul. There's 30 seconds on the shot clock now. You know that Virginia State wants to use some time. Let them.
You're right. Good passes. That's all you got to do. And they're doing just what they need to do.
Now the shot clock is below 20.
70-66 the score.
Still good. They got time. They got 10 seconds.
And knocked away.
Good defense that time by Norfolk State. The shot clock will not reset itself. It's at 8.
Yeah, they're playing great defense, Greg.
See, the offense of Virginia State, even now with the pass inside, they were never in sync. And number 40, Coles, almost came up with a fine defensive effort.
8 seconds on the shot clock. They force it up. And Coles wins the battle of the loose ball.
Jerome Coles went to the goal to get that one, and he did get it.
Throughout the tournament, Norfolk State has come from behind to upset people. Way off the mark.
Uh-oh. You got a 3-on-1 here.
And again, Lamont Walker cannot throw it in the ocean.
I thought he got fouled.
That's short again.
They're going to come. They're going to come with it.
Walker.
Blackwell on the
foul. I think he got fouled.
Lamont He cannot buy a basket. Charlie Christian wants a timeout.
They need a timeout.
72-66, 1:38 remaining. And when we come back, not that we're going anywhere here, but when they finish this timeout, this talk, Blackwell will be on the line to try to complete a three-point play set. Blackwell will be going to the free throw line, and he'll be trying to complete the three-point play. But again, look at Lamont Walker with the wide open shot. He just cannot buy a basket tonight.
But he's
missed about 11 baskets, and they've all been close shots like that. But fortunately, Blackwell was there for the follow-up, and he does complete the three-point play. 73-66, big free throw. 7-point lead with a minute 38 to go. The clock has not moved. The clock was slow getting going. They went down the court about 3 seconds before the scoreboard clock ever moved. And there's a three-pointer for Jerome Garrett.
He must be the designated three-point shooter.
And there's that half-court pressure, and they tied him up. That's
Norfolk
what they got to do.
Will get the ball on the alternate possession. 73-69, the score. 1:11 remaining. Another nail biter. We'll go right down to the wire. Stiff for three. No. Holds for the over the back foul.
Well, at least he stopped the clock.
103 remaining.
And he's got to make the front end of the 1-1.
And you got a man, Walker, going to the line, who is struggling offensively right now.
He does push early.
Yeah, he pushes.
Pushes early, but he does need to push because he's got a height advantage.
I said Walker going to the line. I correct myself. Ellis will be going to the line with an opportunity to go up by 5.
This is where the free throws are so important. 71% shooter. No.
There's a lot of time left.
We used to call this winning time.
Big follow-up basket by Clinton Wright. Norfolk State calls timeout.
And it was a good timeout, but right now, with 40.
There's a 3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. 45 on the shot, 48 on the game. When we come back, the Trojans will have the ball, leading by 2.
Attention all full-time undergraduates of a black college or university. This message is for you. Black Entertainment Television and the Xerox Corporation are proud to announce the 2nd annual Black College Essay Awards. 3 essays will be selected. The winners will receive $1,500 and will be honored during an award ceremony here on BET. College is a very exciting and challenging time as you prepare to enter America's mainstream and to become a vital part of the middle class. Thus, we are asking you to express your thoughts on this topic. What should the black middle class do to improve the social and economic conditions of the black underclass? A very sensitive and complex question that will require much thought. For complete instructions, go to your student or academic affairs office. Do it now, because all materials must be postmarked by March 18th. Again, undergraduates, what is the responsibility of the black middle class to the black underclass? Think about it. After all, someday, the responsibility could be yours.
Leonard Harris picks up the personal foul. At least he wasn't going to allow him to shoot the three-pointer out there, right?
No way. And now he's got to make